to be on Robbie's table because it seems like Robbie kind of wants to play experiment with Dr. Frankenstein a little bit.
Well, when you see him on Robbie's table, you know, he's trying to give the impression that he doesn't want to be a zombie, and I think maybe he doesn't want to be a zombie. But I think there's a lot that he enjoys about being a zombie, so he's gonna want to ride this out as long as he can.
So he's gonna be playing a willing participant.
Yeah. Whereas you know Liv, she's struggling with her newfound zombieism, and Blaine has less of a moral compass than she does. So he's kind of relishing in it a little bit. Yeah.
Was Blaine creating a following? Is that, we have already seen him create at least one zombie, you know, in addition to Liv.
Yes. And you're going to see. Thank you. You're going to see some of his zombie army, his henchmen, as the season progresses. And you're going to see inside of Blaine's operation, his brain dealing operation. And, you know, he needs some henchmen, he needs some muscle to protect that operation and to help make deliveries.
It's almost like they're, it's kind of a different way of the vampire kind of making the underworld and the hierarchy, yeah. But it's with zombies. Are you guys kind of conscious of that, or is it more happening organically?
I think, you know, it happens organically, like in the writer's room, they're batting around ideas and you know, how, you know, can you become a zombie? And there's so many ways you can become a zombie. And I think in episode 2, you know, I have sex with a lady and she becomes a zombie. So it can be assumed that through sex, sexually transmitted zombieism, STZ, you know, and it can just come from a scratch. It can come from sex, it can come from, you know, many different things. Yeah. Go ahead, please.
Do you think there's an intentional reason why Liv was chosen to become a zombie?
No. I think when Blaine became a zombie, it was the same time as she became one, and it was a big, massive freak out at that lake party, so... I think just, you know, people were becoming zombies and zombies were making people into zombies, and it's a whole, yeah, it was just chaos, yeah.
So obviously the show is exploring a lot of Liv and the effect of the brains on her and her personality. Is that going to be explored with you at all? We haven't really seen how the brains your character is eating affect you.
Yeah, you know what, I'd like to promise you that, but I can't. I'm like, well, yeah, when am I going to be able to go into a trip? When are you going to see my trip? Next season.
Has there been an episode or an upcoming episode that was particularly forward to film? That was your favorite.
Oh, wow. Yeah, the episode four is pretty, yeah, it's next episode. Yeah. Yeah. There's some stuff. There's an end button in that where it's like, what? I'm getting away with this? The finale is really gory. I was really surprised at the amount of blood and guts and we got away with that CW let us get away with. Sometimes they tell us to tame it. Sometimes they tell us more. It's been a... Yeah. There's a lot of blood coming.
What do the brains taste like?
The brains are... The prop people seem to think that they've found the perfect brain. But for Rose and I to eat, it's not so perfect. Aesthetically, it's pleasing and it looks great. Taste-wise, not so much. We have a spit bucket on standby. So, as soon as cut. But, I mean, what, you know, there's scenes where you just gotta swallow. You're swallowing. Like, when it's on you, you have to swallow over and over again. Like, 10, 20 takes in a row. It's like, but I'm a one-take pony, so I always get it in one.
Well,
to wrap up,
maybe you could talk a little about Blaine and Liv's relationship as it carries through the rest of the season.
Well, I mean, you know, in that second episode, you don't know if they can... they can be like zombie sounding boards and be each other's confidant. And then by the end of that, she doesn't want to be part of that. So, yeah, there's, you know, I'm the antagonist or her protagonist, and it's gonna be us, you know, me trying to ruin her life, and yeah.
My source then.
Yeah.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys.